Hello everyone, today we have an update build video for both Spectre and Deadeye. Both builds are pretty good, and they have almost the same DPS amount, so it's up to you to choose which one you prefer to play. So let's start with Spectre. When EOD released, Spectre was pretty simple, using skill 3 as a main source of damage, and enter Shadow Shroud to restore health and bonus barriers. But thanks to DNet, they released a patch, as usual.
No! God, please, no! 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 No!
They reduced the health cap of Shadow Shroud by more than 60%. Yes, Spectre was broken in both World Sword and PvP, but here's the issue. The nerf included PvE as well. I don't know what the f*** ain't it we're thinking. Now consuming Shadow Strait is basically useless right now. It's not worth using it to support allies anymore. So I made a new backup plan. We can use Shadow Art trait line to inflict passive poison stacks damage from stealth attacks, to restore health and to generate barriers. And to make it even better, we're going to combine it with Aristocracy Rune to generate 25 might stacks to increase the damage even more. You get 5 might stacks from Deadly Art trait lines and another 5 stacks from Shadow Art traits. This new build version has better damage and better passive healing compared to the old build. The basic damage rotation is simple. Use a skill 3 to inflict damage, then skill 5 to enter stealth, then finally skill 1 to do a stealth attack. By repeating this method, you reach the maximum might stacks. Also able to reach up to 40 poison stacks if you combine it with 1000 needles skill. Note this, the pulse damage from 1000 needles skill might reveal you from stealth. So in order to avoid this, once you cast 1000 needles skill, enter Shadow Shroud and use both skill 2 and skill 4 to deal damage. During that, the pulse's damage will be over, and you will be able to re-enter stealth again. As for AoE cleaves, for Spectre, you can use Shroud skills 2 and 4 to cleave mobs, and 1000 needles and dagger 4 while you are not in Shroud. Unlike other specs, Spectre don't have much initiative, so in case you missed hitting your target with dagger 5, you can use either healing skill or utility skill, Blinding Powder, as a backup. Your condition removal is Sigil of Cleansing. By placing weapons in this order, you will be able to swap weapon to remove 3 conditions every 9 seconds. But if you want to equip shortbow in the other hand for group farming during meta events, you can enter Shadow Shroud to remove conditions instead, since entering Shroud also counts as a weapon swap. You can use also Shadow Shroud as a second health bar to block incoming damage as well. As for the gear we're using in this build, we can use full Trailblazer gear that we used in the old build version, or we can use Celestial gear as well. Both will have the same output damage, so it's up to you to pick which one you will craft. That's everything you need to know about Spectre. For now, enjoy watching the rest of the build showcase.
been by that time.
"3 years ago, I made a Deadeye build video. The build got buffed when Aenet reworked Shadow Arts for extra damage and passive self-healing. The playstyle are still the same, nothing changed, but many people in my Discord requested to see how it will perform with the current patch. So let me explain how Deadeye works. When you use F1 skill to mark your target, you will get 1 malice stack per skill that costs initiative. And if it crit, it will give 2 stacks. Once you reach 7 stacks of malice, you will get all these spoons, and you can reset the malice stacks by using stealth attack to deal higher damage per stack, and to be able to start refilling them again to maintain these spoons permanently. So in this build, we're going to use celestial gear for these reasons. To provide decent crit chance to generate stacks faster, boon duration to help keep the boons always uptime, and since pistol skills have a good base power and condition damage, we will benefit from all celestial stats. The rotation is simple. Mark your target with F1 skill, then use skill 3 3 to 4 times. Once you reach 7 menace stacks, use skill 5 to enter stealth, then use skill 1 to do stealth attack to deal high damage and to reset menace stacks to 0, and repeat the process again. As for utility skills, I promoted 1000 needles as an extra utility damage, but since skill 3 teleports you backward away from the boss to keep you safe, the boss will walk away from the utility trap, which makes it tricky to use. So for simplicity's sake, we're going to use poison venom utility instead. But keep in mind, the utility poison venom also applied from Shadow Art as well. You can't stack venom above 6 stacks, and since Shadow Art will provide 3 stacks when you enter stealth and another 3 once you leave stealth, the utility will overwrite the stacks and you won't benefit from it. So here what you can do to avoid this. Once you do stealth attack, use a skill 3 to teleport backward. At this time, you will consume all the 6 venom stacks from Shadow Art. Then you can use utility venom to combine it with the skill 3 chain attack. You can remove conditions every time you enter stealth by using skill 5 or healing skill or even elite skill. You can also enter stealth by using the F2 skill only once you reach 7 malice stacks, and that's good, because if you enter stealth before reaching 7 malice stacks, you will lose damage and boons. So always keep in mind to reach 7 malice stacks before entering stealth. That's everything you need to know about this build. For now, enjoy watching the rest of the showcase, and I will see you later in the next one.